Well, what you want us to do?
Get back to work. I just want to move. Chris, tell our people the tool up. I'm on it.
Shit changed, nigga. Oh, that's the cat. Yeah, look at him. He fly again, boy. He fly than a motherfucker in that green, man. Niggas be buying J's before they pay their rent. Never.
Still from us, motherfucker. Hmm? Huh? Go get the rank to y'all.
I used to see them same motherfuckers all the time, bro. That was balling. Had all the chain jewelries, had clothes, fresh ass clothes, kicks, everything. But you owe people money though.
You know the man works for us. You keep going at him like that, ain't gonna be nothing left of him to make right what he owes.
That's right. Cuddy. OG. Y'all really got me fucked up, nigga. I'm coming back. He dead.
Bitch got to pay.
Hey, yo, check his pockets, yo.
Why the fuck you just sat there and just let these young niggas just run wild and do this irresponsible dumb shit, bro? Why you just let that shit just happen, bro? Take some command. Take some control, man. Put these young niggas under your wing, nigga, and teach them something different than what the fuck ignorant shit that they already know, bro. Avon fucking free, my nigga. Now, I'm going to take this time, you feel me? I'm going to take this moment to restate something I said previously in the past. And I've spoken on this probably 2 or 3 times by now, maybe. But I always fail. And that's on me. Like I said, I use the word fail for a reason. I always fail at finishing my statement, cuz. Now, when it comes to Johnny and what happened to him, you feel me? It's in episode 1 of season 1. Now, of course, bro, if you fucking scam someone or you play someone over some fucking money, there will be consequences. You better expect and know that there will be consequences. But what they did to him, you feel me? Making him fucked up to where he can't fucking, he can't pee correctly. You feel me? That's uncalled for, my nigga. And Johnny had every right to fucking go back to every one of them with a fucking gun and put a bullet in each of their heads, bro. I promise you that. But that wasn't right, cuz. And not especially not over no fucking $20. Now, I've already said that wasn't right. That ain't right, you feel me? To fuck him up, to jump him like that. That wasn't right. But what I always said was, I understand why they did that. You feel me? But what's wrong and what I failed to always bring up and say was that was excessive and that was uncalled for over $20 or whatever, bro. Now a nigga can't fucking pee right. A nigga do that to me, bro. Expect. Expect. And no, motherfucker. Let's go, bro. What the fuck y'all mean, bro? The king stay the king, bro.
You come pick me up in a motherfucking Ford.
Y'all come pick the king up in the Ford, nigga. The fuck you mean, man? The king is home, bruh. Let's go. Let's put these motherfuckers in the dirt, bruh. Like, where Marlo at? Let's go.
Escape. Let's say never again. And that's the only fucking thing I want to take with me from this place.
I told them feds, I said I'm never going back. I'm from Marcy, and Marcy don't raise no rats. Now we can settle this shit, because Stringer or nobody else ain't doing shit. The fuck? Motherfuckers need to get dealt with. Free Weebay.
The Hoppers wouldn't listen. What makes you think these guys will?
These lieutenants running the corners. And I personally feel their pain. Now, middle management means that you have just enough responsibility that you gotta listen when people talk. And not so much that you can tell anybody to go fuck themselves.
That's like his position, really. He just described his own position. In all this, middle management.
Look, my major just wants to talk. That's all. Promise.
I ain't got nothing to talk about, bro.
Ain't gonna happen.
That's a bar, nigga. I ain't got nothing to say to your major or to any of you. What
the fuck you mean it ain't gonna happen?
You heard me, nigga.
Tell you something, motherfucker. We got orders to bring your sorry ass down the way for a sit down with our boss. Now we're prepared to take you with us right now. We can either do this the easy way.
Brain dead fucks.
Major wants the dickhead. You gotta go.
I think he gets a pass this time.
Don't none of us fear you.
I mean, you want, he goes.
Another time, Hurt.
Yeah, another time, you bitch. Now, this scene is very interesting, bro, because I noticed a few things that I don't remember for a fact if I noticed these things on my first initial watch. But when that bitch, that fucking, he don't even deserve a name, bro. He don't even deserve to be called by the name his mama gave him, bro. He don't. But I'm gonna continue on. When that man, he ain't even a man, bro. You can't even call, you can't even use that to describe him. When that person, that malicious motherfucker right there got in Marlo's face, you feel me? And the other cat went to reach, you feel me? I don't think I noticed that the first go around. Here's one thing that I find that's dope was the next second when the camera appears back on Marlo, you see him looking over to his side because his eyes ain't in contact with that ghoul in front of it. Well, whatever that motherfucker, he was looking to the side, bro, and he was shaking his head like, no, you feel me? Chill out. Nah, I want to know, was he really looking at that dude and telling him no, or was that those facial expressions from Marlo really just another reply again to this motherfucker in front of him? You feel me? Like, no, I'm not going with you nowhere, cuz. And I find that to be dope, especially Carver being the only one aware of their surroundings, you feel me? And looking around and like, hey, we fucking outnumbered here, cuz. And these motherfuckers don't fear us. Another time, Hurt.
Now you move your people in any designated area I told you about, and you'll have immunity. Won't nobody bother you. You got my word on it.
What do you get out of this?
That's a fair question. I want to salvage what's still worth salvaging in my district. And I can't do that with a bunch of young hoppers running around scaring the hell out of decent people. I motivate you, and you motivate them.
Nah, that's the trap.
Oh, it definitely is. Oh, it definitely is, my nigga.
And you watch. You see if it don't work out the way I say.
Nothing personal against you, Chief, but what happens if we buck?
We gonna indict every corner, every day.
Every day.
There gonna be some biblical shit happening to you on the way to that motherfucking jail wagon. You understand me?
Biblical shit.
So think it over. I swear to God, come Monday, your world and mine ain't gonna be the same.
That's a bar. Alright. Officer Calvin. If that is your name. Yeah. That old woman. Motherfuckers. Get to it, Officer Calvin. Damn, look at her, man. She needs some help. Nothing personal against you, Chief, but what happens if we don't? I love Bodie, man. I love Bodie as a character, bro. And I love the growth. You feel me? The growth, cuz. Just in this, bro. This ain't the same person. You feel me? That punched that police. Which, again, another thing in season one that I tripped about. You feel me? But had really no reason to trip about because Bodie was in the wrong right there. You feel me? Just like every time, nigga, all these police be brutalizing people and I say they in the wrong. Bodie was in the wrong right there as well. But fuck that punk ass police that he hit too with his bitch ass. Where he at right now? Trying to fall down some stairs for a check and shit with your punk ass. Get the fuck out of here with that. I love Bodie's growth. Just the respect, you feel me? I ain't got no problem with you, Chief. But I just love the growth, man. in the just the demeanor, his choice of words, you feel me, and this the respect.
Low man up on B tier, one of his boys in the dormitory. His brother's tight with the girlfriend of that boy that shot that police.
This nigga's a rat. Little man. Little man dead, huh?
Now, I ain't sure yet if that dink be dink dink or inky dink or maybe fat dink. Then again, it might be flat nose dink.
The fuck you talking about?
Nah, that can't be him. That dink dead.
That dink dead. Oh, fuck.
Look, man, do it have to be the cop's gun? Because if it's guns you want, I can get you guns.
Motherfucker, you wasting my time, nigga. What the fuck? Fuck you, bruh. I can get you some guns. That's stupid, bruh.
I remember this. Sixth grade, Miss Holly's science class. Box lunches taste like shit.
She had some lunch.
I just figured if I told anybody but you, you might think I'm riding a rock.
What makes me think you ain't?
I'm fucking, yo.
Today, me, Tucky, Lil Mikey, man, we all, a bunch of us got scooped up by the police.
Well, you shouldn't sell drugs.
What? Are you serious, my nigga? Are you serious? Hold up, bruh.
It.
Yeah, just that and the boy Marlo.
Yeah, I'm on it.
You better, motherfucker. Fuck, nigga. Should have been on it. Motherfuckers batted your soldiers, nigga. I ain't did shit, nigga. What the fuck is wrong with you? Now, but going on, I ain't like how he did Bodie right there, bruh. Like, stop playing with me, bruh. Bodie has been a loyal, stand-up cat for y'all this entire time. Ain't never turned on y'all. Ain't never talk sideways about any of y'all. Ain't never made no move going no other way than what he's supposed to do. You feel me? He a loyal cat. I don't like how he just disrespected him.
This here the spot, cause Tucky says you supposed to set up shop here. Amsterdam.
Yeah, set up anywhere inside where we got the white flags.
Amsterdam. This is an interesting idea. I want to see how it work, how it goes. Ain't none of this shit legal, though. Nothing about this Amsterdam shit. Ain't none of this shit legal, cuz. This is crazy. Calvin is really some shit. Ain't none of this shit legal. Y'all working together and shit. The dope boys and the police. This ain't none of this legal. This is crazy.
Knocko. Money comes back right now.
Yeah, take your ass down the block. You coming with us. You coming with us.
You call, we haul.
This bitch. Ain't he from season one? This punk ass motherfucker that don't do no work or is incompetent in his job. I can't remember the which.
Commissioner. I know that you're aware that a state witness in a recent city homicide prosecution was killed.
We are treating that incident with the highest priority.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, shooting of the boy on the lot at Lake Clifton High School was a high-profile case, wasn't it, Commissioner?
Yes, it was.
And yet a key witness in the case...
Nah, don't lay off. They can keep going. Keep going. Digging that motherfucker's chest. Fuck them.
Did you see Burrell sweat?
Punk ass.
The hell got into you?
You did, old buddy. You did.
It's all about when and where you decide to do things, though. And for Carcetti, that wasn't the right time and place to do all that. But that's good that the other homie feels inspired, though. Man, fuck everything I just told y'all, bruh. Carcetti's words don't mean shit. Carcetti's feelings don't mean nothing. at the end of the day, bruh. The fuck was you doing in there? Did it because of you. He don't mean what he say. They brought all the fucking fiends. None of this shit is legal, bro. This is a real TV show. It's like, has this ever happened? This can't be real. None of this ain't never happened in history. It's gotta be. Ain't nothing legal about any of this shit. They just gathered up all the fiends in a van and took them to where the dope boys is at. This shit is really crazy. I have never seen this shit in my life or in TV at all. This is a crazy storyline that I think is so fire and dope. Yo, much love to Johnny, cuz, again, bro. They took that nigga out of the van. He was looking around like, what the fuck going on out here, bro? He was looking at the police like, he kept like, what the fuck going on? I love it. Much love to Johnny, man. Much love to the actor, cuz. The police is responsible. The police got a role in Johnny's death, you feel me? They just brought him. They just brought him to his burial site. You feel me? Against his own will, too. Ain't that something?
What do we got?
There's binoculars on the floor.
B&E. B&E Enterprises at work. You feel me?
Marlo making a move.
So that's Chris. That they was talking about Marlo's right hand.
Forget the beating. It ain't about that. You smart, man. I can see that.
That make you motherfuckers look weak talking about forget the beating.
Trust to speak, but goddamn. Only bugs and this motherfucker gonna have legs.
Staying quiet. Staying quiet.
You a student of history? You know this town had its share of smart players, man. Melvin, Little Will. Oh, real smart, man. Real smart. But you know, as soon as their names rang out, bam, feds is on them. You got that titled in your aunt's name or some shit? Now, when they come get you, that straw purchase out there gonna come bite you in the ass, boy. That's what they do. Turn your money against you.
That's a bar. He's snapping. He's snapping, cuz.
That's what I'm offering you, man.
All right, hold up. Alright. That was a great scene, yo. And Stringer said all the right things, you feel me? Everything Stringer said is truth. Truth to everything he just said. And it was a very interesting big learning experience, I feel, for Marlo, actually. Because many things he learned. One, he learned about his car, you feel me, and how that's going to fuck him over later. So let's see if he do something about that. Let's see how he move from here on and see if he learned from what Stringer just said. But also in that, he learned about washing and cleaning your money from what Stringer just said. Marlo let off, like, he don't got none of that shit. He's just a regular street cat that started some, he got some big shit going on the streets, but he ain't got that business side, you feel me, that Stringer does with washing money and doing all these things. And so he learned a lot right there. But he spoke the least. And this is true to every scene we've seen him in. So I'm curious to see how he's gonna react to this situation. Cause I don't think he want nothing to do with these motherfuckers. You feel me? I think he wanna be the king. he want Avon's spot, I feel. So everything Stringer is saying and everything Stringer is doing with organizing this commission, and having peace on the streets between all these different organizations and gangs and groups, is a smart thing. Because less violence on the streets, and everybody gets paid. But Marlo, from what we've seen and what we've heard, especially from last episode, Marlo is a monster, nigga. He ain't with none of this shit. And again, him being quiet and just listening, he gonna take in all this information and as well size up the Barksdale crew. Because you already got right here where he, where Stringer says, this ain't about that. This ain't about the beating. None of that. I don't care about none of that. That already makes y'all look weak. I don't think that's going to work with Marlo. And they gonna, and it's going to cost in the end. We're going to see, though. I love this scene, man. For many reasons. And one of them being Marlo barely speaking. You feel me? The more you talk, the more you reveal about yourself, man. Just how he was measuring Stringer up, you feel me? As Stringer walks by, just the eye contact and just the sizing him up and getting to know what he's really about. And he revealed to me many things. Forget the beating. It ain't about that. You feel me? Okay, he ain't about that pressure, cause he just let go of a beating of about 20 of his men. And then you bring up all these different things your mind is open to, you feel me, and are about, and you offering these things to this young hood nigga that don't give a fuck about none of that, you feel me, at this point in time. All this young hood nigga right here, the only thing that this man wants is what you got, you feel me, everything that you got, because y'all run in the same jungle. On the same side, you feel me, of the jungle. And it don't matter nothing you saying. Only thing that Marlo got out of any of this was that they're weak. You feel me? They're weak. And now is the time. But it was also a learning lesson at the same time, bro. No matter who talking, you can get something. You feel me? And I'm pretty sure, I don't remember correctly right now, but I'm pretty sure he got something out of what Stringer told him about his car. You feel me? I can't remember right now, but I'm pretty sure. And that's dope. To some people, there's no compromise. You feel me? To some people, there's no making deals. You want it to be one way, but it's the other.
Chris, tell our people to tool up.
It's done.
I'm on it.
We going to war. It's done. My nigga, say less. He told me after that meeting, his first thing to say in order to give is to tool up. Everybody get strapped in the crew. It's done, bro. He ain't with none of this peace shit. He ain't with none of this working together, none of that shit. He want to be the sole ruler, nigga, of the jungle. And let's go. Avon Free, bro. Let's go. This scene right here is one of the greatest declarations of war ever in any series. Real, nigga, what? Real, three words, bro. Chris. Seven words. Chris, tell our people to tool up. And you know what the motherfucking zombie master said, nigga. I'm on it. That nigga's a zombie. I can't wait for the next couple episodes. Oh my god, we gonna get into it, cuz we gonna get into Chris Partlow. You feel me? The introduction of Chris Partlow. Greatness, my nigga. We gonna get into it, yo.
The integrated math program. In the previous schools, Michael took introductory algebra, but I understand that this school is doing something different.
We are. The integrated math
program. Excuse me, I'm a little thirsty. Can I get either of you something to drink?
He ain't shit. That nigga ain't shit, bro. Oh, he really ain't, man. Oh, what's happening? I caught your eye, did I? What's happening?
The math program offers tutoring possibilities. So if Michael finds it difficult adjusting, we can have...
Are you serious? Don't start with this bullshit, bro. Bro. Fuck out of here with all that. Don't look at me talking to no woman, bruh. Don't even dare look. You look away.
I mean, it was the math integration class for my oldest. He's in sixth, seventh. And
sixth, seventh? He don't know. What's happening, big sis?
Oh, man. I just wish I wasn't the only one coming home, you know?
That's a fucking bar, man. Damn, cuz, that's a bar, real shit.
We'll talk later.
Motherfuckers still need to pay what they owe. Motherfuckers, fuck all them East Side bitches.
Right there to cut and tie yourself. Any dollar you spend now is gonna come back to you 10 times.
you've been through. I know, because I'm from the same streets. And once I had the chance to play a different game, there wasn't a question in my mind how to go.
Man, Avon is the streets. Clay Davis, smart, corrupt ass. Shit. Damn, I failed at that, cut.
You see the two niggas right there? You over here getting high in the middle of all this. Now where the fucking discipline at, yo? Fuck. Toss them niggas.
Avon is still Avon, bro. Are them two cats that... them ignorant ass cats from... I love this scene. Quick fucking minute, bro. I love this scene. This part right here. That's what's needed. Back in this bitch. You feel me? Where's the respect? You feel me? Where's the discipline out here, cuz? And what I really am going to love to talk about in the upcoming episodes is the changes in Avon himself, you feel me? And his lack of discipline for his own rules, you feel me? As he once did abide by in season one, heavy. Welcome home, King.
Yo, You remember when we used to sit on the top of 734 building, man, looking at the city? You talk about what we gonna do?
And you was all heavy into that black pride bullshit. Talking like you gonna get you two grocery stores and make motherfuckers proud.
Sure was, man. You was out hunting on a AK-47. Talk about I'm gonna go get Warren.
Motherfuckers in the streets. He said, y'all saw his mouth, bro. He was like, oh, that's the end of the episode. Fuck, man, this episode's been good, yo, to where like I don't even realize it's about to end, man. Oh, half this shit didn't even record my face. Fuck. Damn, that shit just pissed me off, man. Fuck. Oh, well. This conversation is very fucking interesting, you feel me? And got me thinking, like, Stringer could have went down a whole nother fucking path, you feel me? When he was younger, he had different views and ideals and the way he went about things and what he saw for himself. But I think what really made the turn for him was the money. And that's what it is with all these capitalistic motherfuckers, you feel me? The money, that's what seduced him and that's what changed him. He went from having black pride and this and that and wanting to build up his community, wanted to do something good for his community, some grocery stores, you know, some real produce for our people, you feel me? Instead of all this all this nonsense that's not good for any of us, you feel me? That's pumped with so much different things that none of us don't even fucking know about. Like, it's crazy. So he had a whole nother vision and way of thinking and future for himself, bro. But it was the money. That's what seduced him and that's what turned him, I believe. And Avon has always been Avon. The streets is the streets. Always. You feel me? Oh, that's it for The Wire, Season 3, Episode 5, man. Much love to all my family, man. If you enjoyed my video, man, please leave me a like, leave me a comment. My Patreon link is down below, man. I appreciate all my supporters, man. Thank you so much. And my YouTube family holding me down always, man. I'm grateful that y'all take y'all time out of y'all days to watch my videos, man. So I appreciate that. Y'all stay in high spirits. You, your kids, your family, treat one another with respect. You feel me? Don't degrade one another and always be aware, man. Y'all be safe. I love all y'all. Peace, fam.